Hi guys, in this video I'll show you how to slice animated PowerBI dashboard for different matrices. I'll show you how to further customize the animated infographics we created in part 1 of this project. First, we'll add a slicer to switch between the different matrices, then we'll customize the animated visuals to update values based on the selected value. Then we'll update the three animated infographics showing on the bottom of the dashboard, and synchronize them with the race bar visuals to show always the top three countries showing in the race bar visual. Before we start, make sure to subscribe to this channel to stay updated with unique and exciting business intelligence projects. If you haven't watched part one of this project, don't worry, I have left you a link in the description you can watch after we finish here. Now, grab a cup of coffee, sit back and watch.
Okay guys, this is the dashboard we created in part 1 of this project. The two visuals on the top of this dashboard are always showing CO2 emissions. So what we want to do here, we want to be able to switch between the different matrices. The CO2 emission, the renewable energy share, and the total energy consumption. And to do this, we'll start by creating a new table to switch between the three matrices. So from modeling, new table, I have it prepared, let's just paste it. So this table will add a column called series and show CO2 emissions, top 10 countries, renewable energy and final energy. Let's hit OK. Now we'll delete the title for the dashboard and add a slicer. For this slicer, we'll feed the new field we created. Let's change the start drop down. Let's just move it in the top and resize it and turn off the slicer header, and from value, change the font size to 30 and the font color also we change it, and maybe we add border for the values with align width of 3, and from general, let's turn off the background. Let's see how it looks like. Let's also change the slicer background color to black. Now it looks better with a separator between each of the matrices. Let's also, from slicer settings, change the selection to single select. Now after we created this slicer, we need to add a measure that will allow us to switch between the different matrices. So let's add a new measure. I have the values ready, I'll just paste it. So we'll use switch function to check if we're selecting CO2 emissions, it will give us the sum of CO2 emissions. If renewable energy, it will calculate the renewable energy share, and if it was final energy consumption, it will take the total energy consumption. Now we select the race bars and we replace the value with the new measure we created. Let's just remove the old one, and if we now test it, let's switch to final energy consumption for example. We can see the values, the bars values are updated. Now we need to do the same for the line.visual. Let's test it. Switch to final energy and we can see both are updating. Let's play it and see if it works. Looks good. Now for the line.visual, if you remember, we are using the global total emission, while for the race bars we are using only the top 10 countries. But for the energy matrices, we only have the top 10 countries. So we need to standardize the countries across all the three matrices. To do this, we'll go to transform data and go to the CO2 emission table and eliminate the option for the world. So we'll keep only the top 10 countries. Let's go back. One more thing we need to do here, we need to make the title dynamic. To do this, let's go to general, title, and use conditional formatting, and we'll use the field value as the series name. OK. And we need to do the same for the rest parts which one. Here we go, now let's test it. If we switch to CO2, we can see the titles are updated and the values are updated as well. Now for the rest bar, let's remove the grids to make the switch between the matrices smoother. Now for the values cards, we need also to remove the word filter and also change the value to the series measure. Let's test it now. We can see the value card is showing on top of the line. Let's move it upward a little bit. And let's also move the play controls. Okay guys, here we get to the more challenging part. We can see that the three visuals on the bottom here are always showing the same countries. And they're showing the top three countries with CO2 emissions for the year of 2015. But for example, if we go to a previous year, let's for example select here 2000, we can see we have different top three countries, United States, China and Russia. And also when we switch the slicer, for example, to renewable energy share, we can see we have a different list of top three countries. So what we want to do here, we want to make sure that always the top three countries showing in the race bars are always showing for those three visuals. To do this, we'll start by creating ranking columns for each of the matrices. Starting by CO2 emissions, we create a new column. First, we'll take 1 year, then we use rankX function. We slice the table for this year and we show the rank as descending based on the emission value. Let's see how it looks in the table. We can see that the ranking has been created from 1 to 10. Let's for example look to a specific year. Let's filter for 1990. We can see we have 10 ranks created. Let's sort emission descending. And we can see the order is showing from 1 to 10. Now we need to repeat this for both renewable energy and total energy. We can see here two columns are created in the energy table, one for total energy and one for renewable energy. Next step, for each of the ranks, we will see the top three countries. Starting by total energy here, we can see that we have China, India, Russia and United States across the years. Now let's remove the filter and apply the filter for the renewable energy. We can see also those four countries, Canada, China, India and Indonesia. Now let's do the same for CO2 emissions. We can see that we have four countries. So in total we have six countries. Now let's switch to PowerPoint and update the design we created in part one. We don't need the extra two slides, we just need one slide. What we're going to do here, we'll start by United States. We'll change the color to the same color we're using in the race bars, to be able to select it later. Next step, we'll import the other countries. We'll start, for example, by China. Let's place it on the top here, resize it a little bit, and change the color to the same color we used in the race bars. So here we go. Now we need to repeat the same process for the rest of the six countries and put it all on top of each other. And I also updated the icon for the energy consumption because we are gonna animate it later. So let's export this, save as, browse, make sure to select SVG format, name it maps, and save. Just this one. Now back to PowerBI. Let's delete the two visuals and keep only one. Now let's expand it from edit, change image, and bring the one we just created. Let's make sure to keep the configuration for the layers so it can save us some time. We can see here we lost some of the formatting of the numbers. Let's just recreate them like we did in part one. Next, we go to filters and we remove the country filters. We're not gonna use the country as a filter anymore. Instead, we'll use the rank. But there's one step we need to do here. We need to create a table to use it as a filter. So let's go to modeling, new table, and paste. So we're gonna name it as a rank from 1, 2, 3. So this is the rank table created. Let's feed it to the filter and apply for the first visual 1. Let's lock it. So we want this visual always to show rank 1. Next, if you remember from part 1, in the category we had the country. So now we want this to be dynamics. So we will replace the column with a measure. Create a new measure, right click, new measure, and paste. So this measure will always check the rank first, and then based on what we're selecting, if it's CO2, it will give us the country for this rank, and the same for the other two matrices. Then it will use a switch function based on the selected matrix. It will filter the country table to the country with the selected rank. And this applies the same for the three matrices. Let's click OK. Now let's feed the new measure in the value field. Now we start to configure the different countries. We can select based on the color, so you need to know each color to what country it belongs. Let's start by United States, for example. Let's update the fill color to gradient, just like what we did in part one. Apply the energy share here for range 2 and range 3. And also change the color to the color field. So we select the color here, apply, okay, again for range 4. Apply. Next we'll use the visibility. So we'll use conditional formatting, if else, based on the measure we created for the country. So let's select that measure. And if it's equal to, let's first change this to text and write United States. Then show it, and we assign 1 to show it and 0 to hide it. So if it wasn't United States, it will be hidden. Sometimes the equal to doesn't apply immediately, so make sure it's applied. Now we need to repeat the same process for all the countries. As you can see here, we still don't see any country because there is one more thing we need to do. Let's take the measure we created for country and drag it to filters and filter it for is not blank. And we can see the countries showing, the top country is showing, which is India. I know this is a bit confusing, so let me show you how this measure exactly works. First, let's copy this visual. And convert it to a table. We can see here it's showing all the fields, including the measure we created.
Let's first remove the major filter and select one of the years, for example 1998. We can see everything is blank except for one country, which is the country that has the first rank for that year. Now if we try to select different years, we can see that, for example here, let's go at the beginning, we still have India here. Here in 1991 we can see Indonesia is the first. Also if we switch to CO2 emissions, we can see, for example, for the selected year, the United States has the top rank. Let's check for another year. Here we go, we have China. So this is how it works. Let's remove it now and go back to configure our visual. Next step here, we want to animate the icons. Let's activate the edit and select this icon. Let's go to animation, fill color animation, and we use custom colors and we make it shift between red and white just to give us an animation feel. And we repeat the same for the other segments for this icon. Let's do the same for CO2 emissions, switch between black and brown. So here we go, we have it animated now, the colors. Let's go back. Now we just copy this visual once and change the rank to 2. So we can see it showing United States. Again, we copy it one more time and change the rank to 3. And it shows India. Now let's test it. Switch to final energy consumption. We can see it shows the correct top 3. For renewable energy, also showing the correct top 3. Now let's hit play and see if it works properly with years. We can see that as the top country changing between India and Indonesia, the infographics are also changing. Let's switch to CO2 emissions, for example, and hit play. We can see it's working as expected. Let's also try for final energy consumption. You can see also it's working as expected. And this concludes this part.
There you have it. Our dynamic, interactive, and beautifully animated dashboard is a reality now, telling a compelling story in the form of a video. I'm confident that this dashboard will hold your audience's attention, keeping their eyes glued to the screen. If you found the content of this project valuable, leave a comment. And if you're new here, make sure to subscribe to this channel. You won't want to miss the next content. In a few seconds, I'll present you with a demo of the dashboard we created during this project. I added some extra animated icons that we didn't cover in the videos of this project. Here is an exciting challenge for you. With both parts of this project under your belt, you're equipped with the tools to create similar animations yourself. So give it a shot. To get you started, you'll find in the description a link for both PowerBI dashboards we created in part 1 and part 2 of this project, along with extra resources. Now, I'll leave you with the demo. Peace!